It's time to get the starting five from your Indiana Pacers. At the other forward, 6'8", number 13, Jalen Warren. At guard, 6'5", number 00, Benedict Mathurin. At the other forward, 6'3", 24, Buddy Hield. In the middle, 6'11", number 33, Miles Turner. Back guard, 6'5", 0, Tyrese Haliburton.
And welcome everyone to the NBA on 2K Sports. Brand new season. So glad to have you with us on this journey. This is Brian Anderson at the table with basketball royalty, Grant Hill and Clark Kellogg. Allie LaForce, our reporter. Allie, it's all yours.
Well, guys, Miles Turner is one of the game's premier rim protectors. He said, quote, "I change games. I'm able to push my team, and they know that when I'm back there, it makes it easier for everybody. I want to show the league what everybody in Indy has known for years, that I'm a defensive anchor, and I take pride in that."
Well, he is a presence, Allie, no question. Thank you. And a look now at the Washington Wizards' upcoming schedule. On Friday, they'll be matching up against DeMar DeRozan and the Chicago Bulls. And then Sunday, they'll be matching up against Donovan Mitchell and the Cleveland Cavaliers. And now the Washington Wizards starters. Bradley Beal's out there with DeLon Wright. Then it's Kristaps Porzingis. Then it's Daniel Gafford. And it's Kuzma in at the small forward position. And for the Pacers, Mathurin and Hield out on the perimeter. Then there's Tyrese Haliburton. Then there's Miles Turner. And it's Nwora in at the four spot. Well, Clark, I think I speak for all of the NBA family in saying that we are eager to get this season underway.
Always, B.A. You know, we love the fact that each new season brings a clean slate for everybody. Players, coaches, announcers, fans. It doesn't matter what you did last season. Everybody starts at ground zero this season. That is room service delivery from right there for the Sweet Nine to create a high percentage shot.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Now here's Kuzma. That one doesn't drop.
Man, I can't believe he blew that gimme, guys. Well, I know he's frustrated about that.
Yes, it's good. Halliburton's got his second basket of the game.
Very good composure and control that time by Haliburton, not allowing that physical defense to affect his shot at all.
And it's rejected. A little over a minute gone here in the first quarter. Oh, it makes it with the kiss. Halliburton's got six.
3 out of 3, perfect start. Let's see how long they can ride this wave.
And that streaking rack attack is the Mobile One drive.
Yeah, he made that drive look easy, but that had a high degree of difficulty.
And the team got excited about that when Wright felt the contact, but still managed to finish through.
Last season, Washington was hot out of the gates. They started 10-3, but things did not end well.
You know, and after that hot start, B.A., a 25-44 ending for the Wizards, failing to make the play-in game as well. Just a disappointing season after the promise Washington showed early.
The Pacers have gone 4-4 from the floor. Perfect start. Here's Turner, and it's Indiana scoring again.
The plan coming in is working. They're perfect 5-for-5 from the floor.
Pass to Porzingis. Three-pointer off the mark. The Pacers have gone 5-of-5 in this quarter. Solid. Here's Mathurin. And the layup falls.
Their offense is looking like a well-oiled machine, getting any look they want.
Boy, this is borderline ridiculous. I mean, every single attempt finding the bottom of the bucket.
And a slam dunk by Porzingis.
Boy, this team takes on a different attitude when Porzingis imposes his will like that. His energy and attitude, infectious.
And the basket by Halliburton.
That makes them 5 for 5 so far. Could be a big night in store.
I think they've got to consider throwing a few different looks his way early on, especially if he keeps shooting like this.
Time called here. The Wizards decide to talk it over.
Time for your Indiana Pacers space, everyone. Let's get excited.
Changing it up here.
Give it up for your Pace Main Stage team.
A minute 58 left in the first quarter. Pass to Avdija. Puts up a three. Doesn't go that time. Indiana on offense. They're on a 14-4 run.
Miles Turner's defensive impact can be enormous. I mean, he is a fierce rim protector, a league shot block leader. You know, teams have to really be mindful of where he is and maybe even shape their offense around avoiding him.
Now here's Porzingis.
How about the bounce?
We can call that bounce per ounce. Can't be denied.
He's a highlight reel, always on the launch pad.
Count the basket. Turner's got 6. And Turner's already led the league in blocks multiple times, Clark.
Yeah, he sure has. And, you know, he's not just all about defense, though, B.A. He's averaged double-digit points every year he's been in the league. And he's a pretty strong finisher at the 10, although I think that's an area that he's got to continue to grow in. And his outside shot has come a long way.
Nora. And the shot counts. He's fouled. And it's a chance for a three-point play.
Denny. Avdija. First personal foul. First team foul. At the line. For Indiana. Jordan Wara. One shot.
One shot.
Look, for the Pacers, I'm part of that franchise's history, so I understand the reality of being a small market team. Likely they don't sign a KD or LeBron in free agency. They've had to build through the draft and make good trades, and I don't have any doubt that they'll be able to do that because they've got some good young pieces and are looking good for the future.
Now here's Smith. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. And it's Indiana scoring again.
So far, they're owning both ends of the floor. We'll see if they can keep this going.
And, you know, nothing like getting an opponent on the ropes early. You love that if you're on that side of the scoreboard, and they are landing some haymakers now.
And so it's Indiana liking their chances, ending the quarter with a 15-point lead. Their defensive efforts have paid off, effectively shutting down the opposing offense. We'll be right back. And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And a look now at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the Pacers.
Getting downhill has really been impressive to me. Not settling from the outside. They're going right to the rack.
You know, another thing that has impressed me has been their numbers of points in the paint. Just dominating down there. They're just getting whatever shot they want in close.
All right, this is how the floor looks for the Wizards starting in the second. Morris and Beal are the backcourt pair. Daniel Gafford is out there with Avdija. And it's Kuzma in at the three. And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Thanks a lot. Well, Brian, the Wizards have been aggressively reshaping their roster. What they haven't done is tear it down and start a rebuild. That's often the most popular route for teams stuck in the middle, but the Wizards seem to be hoping they can catch lightning in a bottle. Back to you.
Now, no appetite for the restart, Allie. Thanks. Now here's Morris. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. That one drops for him.
And you like the balance here, not just falling in love with the three ball.
Here's Nembhard, defended by Kuzma. Count it.
They're punishing those late defensive rotations, getting good looks inside throughout the half.
Morris sets a screen. Gafford finds Kuzma. That one falls. He's now 1-for-3.
Taking on everybody. All comers. Kuzma's very aggressive, and he's used to getting hit on the way up. Plays well through contact.
Morris outside. Pass to Avdija. Gafford with the ball. Clock at 6. Here's Kuzma. Morris for 3. The rebound by Nesmith. Unloads from 13. The shot by Nembhard, no good.
Well, I admire the fact he's trying to power through this rough stretch, but on occasion, you'll have periods like this.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. That's why they continue to get attacked.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness. If they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Now a timeout called by Indiana. Wright's checked in for Washington. Well, Clark, it's getting harder to find players' true positions. We've got bigs who bring the ball up the court. We got guards who defend in the post.
Yeah, it's a very different kind of a game. Actually, we hear this phrase, positionless basketball, all the time, B.A., but the skill level of players is so vast now. I mean, everybody handles the ball, wings and bigs, and you mix and match skills across the court and at every position. So a lot of diversity in the skill set of players in today's game. Tyrese Haliburton, so capable of playing multiple positions and roles for this team. And tonight, he's embraced being the scorer.
Now here's Beal. What, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Turner with it. Beal picks him up. Nice shot by Turner. And the Pacers lead by 13.
Exceptional skills for Turner down in the paint. This guy, I think, has the potential to be a dominant player inside for a lot of years.
And what an aggressive move to the rim. He's really trying to fire up his teammates right now.
Boy, it's not hard to feel inspired after a teammate makes that kind of finish.
You know, when you're looking to close the gap, you need guys who will take it upon themselves to step up, take the initiative, and make something happen.
Now here's Turner. Give him 8 points now. Pass to Haliburton. Over Beal. And Haliburton, the bucket on the assist by Turner. Haliburton's got 16 points now. Time called here. The Wizards decide to talk it over. Here for the Pacers. Norris checked in for Turner, and it's Smith in for McConnell. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. After making the playoffs 5 years straight, the Pacers have struggled to get back to the postseason.
You know, B.A., they're trying to go through a rebuild right now, and that's going to take some time. But the front office and coaching staff appear comfortable with this direction, knowing it might be a while before they make the playoffs again.
Here's Wright. To the middle. Here's Gafford. Hey, he's now 6-for-6. He is cooking right now.
And you know coach loves seeing his offense operate at this level. Great passing out there.
5 straight baskets resulting from assists. They're playing as one unit out there.
Oh, nice one-handed jam there, B.A.
Hey, little exclamation point.
Hey, they've got a nice, comfortable lead here, fellas. Might as well keep it simple. Do it a plain, simple one-hander, just like pound cake.
Right, the pass to Gafford. And he's going to the line for 2. The official saw contact while he was going up.
You know, the Wizards really came up short last season.
And they've stopped the action here. They're using their coach's challenge to see if they can get this foul overturned.
And even with the coach's challenge in place,
the previous play is under review.
Disputed even after the video review.
There's no doubt there's going to be a gray area in a lot of these calls, but at least we have the option to take a second look so the officials can be sure that
the ruling on the floor is confirmed.
And they've made their decision. The call will stand.
And as much as it hurts to lose a challenge, I think Coach would challenge that call again if he could. He really disagreed with the foul, and he's still peeved.
Free throw good from Gafford. Both free throws good from Gafford. There's 42 seconds left in the second. Here's Halliburton, and a nice finish on the layup. Halliburton's got 10 points now, just in this quarter.
He's getting it done offensively, making winning plays at every turn.
Right, the open look. We've got 22 seconds left in the first half.
They've had a slight leg up on the boards and a big leg up on the scoreboard.
Well, you take a look at all of the stats, the team stats, that is, and that's one of the many areas that they've had the advantage. And as a result, they've got a big lead.
That's what you call playing big. He just stays committed to the attack mode.
And sometimes that's the best policy when you're going up against a big guy. Take it to the 10, right at him, get to the rack.
Tyrese Halliburton getting it done for the Pacers. He put together 10 points in the quarter. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Well, I'm here with Coach Rick Carlisle. A hot start. Coach, what did you like about this team's execution offensively?
We were making some shots. We moved the ball well at times. We've got to be careful about having the ball stick when they're doing their switching.
Good luck with the ball movement in the second half. Thanks, Coach.
Allie, as always, thank you. We'll be right back to begin the third quarter right after this.
Hello, everybody. We're here to break it all down. In the first half of play, it's a very commanding lead for the Indiana Pacers.
Their game plan has been pretty straightforward. Attack inside, make the defense collapse, and so far it's been working.
Yeah, I think that the whole team over there collapsed. This is over.
And now, let's take a second here to look at what's ahead on the schedule. And Kenny, were there any specific teams you looked forward to playing?
I mean, any team Shaq was on, because you had to be hyped for that, you know, especially when you got Akeem, when they go head-to-head. I always look forward to that.
Yeah, you're lucky you had him, Kenny, because you were terrified to come down into the paint.
Not true. I wasn't terrified, just a little bit shaky.
Glad you could join us. Ryan Anderson and crew are ready to take it away for the start of the third quarter.
As we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it's been a runaway. Boy, you gotta like what Tyrese Halliburton has done in this game.
They've leaned on him to provide a lot of offense, and that's how he likes it.
And you know what? They've come at him a few different ways defensively, and nothing has slowed him down.
Just about ready for the second half here. A big comeback is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Halliburton and Mathurin man the backcourt together. Then it's Buddy Hield, then there's Miles Turner, and it's Nwora in at the power forward position. So that's the group out there for Indiana. Here's Beal. Pacers with a rebound.
I'll tell you what, they've rebounded the ball tremendously well.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. Strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
In addition to affecting the game at both ends, Mathurin has already proven to be a tremendous leader.
Oh, yes, he has, B.A. He's a high intangibles guy, a hard worker, really leads by example, and he's clutch. He elevates his play in big-time situations.
A moment to hear from Ali LaForce.
Thanks, B.A. Bradley Beal played for Coach Greg Popovich with the U.S. national team, and Pop said, quote, he's hard to keep up with. His balance and movement are very impressive. He stops on a dime, can pull up and shoot. That, along with his excellent footwork, are the most impressive things for me. Brian?
Yeah, great breakdown there, Ali. Thank you. A remarkable defensive play. The replay showing, once again, the tenacity on that end.
Superb anticipation on that rejection, and that'll allow them to stay on the lead if they keep defending like that.
To the inside. Pass to Kuzma. Back to Abdia. And they pick up two. Abdia's gotten his first basket of the night.
Finally get one to drop after starting the half with four straight clanks.
Here's Nembhard, and the layup is good off the glass. And the Pacers lead by 21.
Soft defense. I mean, they've given up 10 of the last 12 points inside.
Oh, and a slam dunk by Morris.
I tell you, a little extra pressure on D when you're up against a point guard who can elevate.
Ha, it doesn't make it easy, does it?
And you know, guys, showing how dynamic a weapon he is for this offense, they feed off of that energy and ability to make plays. It gets them going. Man, what a pass that was there. He really, really relishes making the game easier for his teammates.
Here's Nembhard, guarded by Morris. Here's Nesmith, and connects on the nine-footer. Nesmith's got his first basket.
Yeah, exactly. It sure is. Plenty of second opportunities. 8 of their last 10 points from the paint, but the defense still continues to back away and not show any aggressiveness.
B.A., the one-hand dunk just looks so fluid.
Yeah, absolutely. Even smooth when he's powering it home like that.
Part of what makes him unique, guys, that combination of power and polish.
Yeah, and for the Pacers, things had gotten stale. So they bring in a new coach in Rick Carlisle, a new potential star in Tyrese Halliburton, a fresh start for this franchise. They have no answer defensively inside.
Yeah, and that's 4 straight field goals now they've allowed from point-blank range. Can't happen.
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over.
Here they are, your Indiana Pacers.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. And now a look back at last year's top shooting teams in the NBA. The Wizards in fifth.
You know, after that solid performance last year, there will be a lot of high expectations this year. And nothing stays exactly the same for a team from year to year. There are a lot of dynamics involved, particularly shooting percentages.
The Pacers have gone 6 of 7 and appearing confident in this half. Indiana switching things up recently, going forward in a new direction.
You know, B.A., change can be a good thing. Sometimes organizations can get comfortable winning 42, 44 games, losing in the first round. But the Pacers clearly want more. And you know what? I respect that.
Morris with it, and it's McConnell picking him up. Outside Porzingis. And they get it back. No good on the triple.
And they're +5 on the boards after that rebound.
And it's going to be a goaltending call here, so they will count the bucket.
Kudos for the effort, but he got there a little too late.
102 left in the third. Let's it go from deep. And the rebound goes to the Pacers. Turner's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Outside, Hill. That one goes in.
Pretty flashy display by Hill. Really doing whatever he wants with the ball in his hand.
And we just had to see that mobile one drive one more time. Great stuff.
And this is exactly what you love to see. Up big, not letting up, keep on applying pressure to their defense.
Here's Nunn, Porzingis. He's good with a little jumper in close.
Assist goes to
Porzingis has got 10 points.
Sometimes it's simple. Put the ball in the hands of your scorers and let them do what they do best. And the defense has no one to blame but themselves. I mean, they just let him get right to the rim.
You know, he should be getting extra attention from the defense, not less.
Morris outside. Pass to Porzingis. Just three on the clock. No good on the layup. And so it's Indiana with plenty of breathing room. 23 points to end the quarter. Their efficiency has been off the charts. They're running their sets well with patience and purpose. More NBA on 2K Sports right after this. Rick Carlisle had some advice for his team. Let's hear what he had to say.
Hold your ground. Hold your ground. Your job is just to stay in front of this guy.
And Coach Carlisle preaching strong defense there.
Yeah, basic fundamentals. Doesn't want to see anyone on his team get burned on this end.
And one quarter to go in a game that, to this point, has not been an evenly fought contest. Fourth quarter on the court for the Wizards. Kendrick Nunn out there with Bradley Beal. Then it's Daniel Gafford, then there's Kyle Kuzma, and it's Kispert in a small forward. Here's Halliburton. Well-placed jumper from the free throw line. Halliburton's got 24.
Clearly, Halliburton is hunting his shots. He's not picky and knows exactly how to adjust on the mid-range jump shot.
Hey, we've heard a lot of coaches say, including Warriors coach Steve Kerr, about load management. If you want to see the stars play more often, cut the schedule back. Maybe 72 games. Grant, your thoughts?
You know, B.A., this is a problem and a concern, I think, for the league. You go back 20, 30 years ago, stars played every night when available. Now you're not seeing that with the workload and the back-to-back and the concern with players and their safety and the amounts of money they make over their contracts. 72 games is a possibility, but I prefer to keep it at 82. Maybe I'm just a traditionalist.
And the Pacers making a change here. Heald's checked in. He's perfect from the line this time. Indiana on offense. Earlier, they held a 23-point lead. They'll face the Spurs at home after this one. It'll be the second of three straight games on their home floor.
Now, that was nasty. Absolutely nasty. Halliburton looking like a street baller with that kind of dribble move. Major handles.
Here's Heald. Soft touch off the glass. Heald's got his first 2 points.
That's 10 straight points they've given up in the painted area.
And you know, it doesn't matter how good your defense is on the perimeter if you're going to allow easy ones inside like that.
And it's Kuzma finishing it off.
You know, I think Kuzma's the kind of guy you've got to push out of the paint. When you don't, this is what happened.
Yeah, that one's good. Halliburton's got 6 points in the quarter.
Very little resistance around the rim right now. That's the fifth straight bucket they've given up in the paint.
Those looks they're allowing are almost automatic.
Slick feed by Beal, taking advantage of the hole in the defense to set up a wide open man.
Here's Halliburton, and he comes up with a bucket. Halliburton's got 10 points in just the second half.
I love this game plan. That's 10 points in a row from in close.
If you can't stop it, here it comes. I'm right at you.
And we've heard the cautionary tales in the past. Does it seem like players today are getting better financial advice, in your opinion, Grant, to make their money last?
Yeah, B.A., I think they're getting better financial advice, but I also think that the times that we're in, I think there's more awareness. Players understand the pitfalls or potential setbacks, the social media, digital age, all the information's there. So players today, yes, they're making more money, and I actually think they're doing a better job of protecting and saving their money, too.
Nora. Both free throws good from Gafford. The Pacers have gotten off to a perfect 5-for-5 so far in the fourth. And again, Tyrese Halliburton. Halliburton's got 32 points in the game.
They're finding ways to get the ball into the paint. 5 consecutive buckets. And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
Nora, that's good.
Always a good possession when you can get that kind of look.
Around 3 minutes gone here in the fourth. Beal outside.
2 minutes.
Second chance shot, and he lays it in. Beal's got 5 points in the quarter.
We all know Beal might be a shorter off guard at 6'3", but Bradley has heart. He plays way bigger than that listed height, and he couldn't get an easier shot. The defense right now just looks defeated.
Well, that's exactly the kind of defense that's gotten them into the hole.
Pass to Porzingis. And he banks in the layup.
You know, at 7'3", not many guys can defend Porzingis. I mean, especially when he's operating this close to the rim.
Here's Halliburton. Got it. Good job in the low post. Halliburton's got 16 points here in the second half.
Had their fingerprints all over this matchup tonight. Just an impressive victory for the Pacers.
And you don't usually see this kind of blowout, but tonight they delivered the punishment.
I mean, what's so impressive is they never wavered in their approach. They just kept at it and showed they were without a doubt the better team.
And so this win marks their first victory of the new year.
And against a familiar opponent, it's nice to establish a psychological advantage with a win in the first game.
Especially because they're going to get together 3 more times this season. You love to get an opponent figured out early, and you're going to be seeing them that often.
And when you look at the game, the one thing that helped fuel this team to victory was the efficiency for Tyrese Halliburton.
Boy, this game really had his name all over it. I mean, he relished being the guy to carry the load offensively.
And guys, that's got to be the dagger. This is how you finish a game.
Yeah, what a time to put the hammer down. Any hope of a comeback diminished.
Heel to the ball. Now right defending. 18 feet out. He can't get that one to fall. And Washington the other way now. Pass to Kuzma from behind the arc. The rebound by Turner. Heel to the ball, hounded by Beal. Heel drives in, soft touch off the glass.
Their home crowd has energized them all game. Now they're closing it out.
And I think they can start that celebration right now. I mean, what a terrific team victory.
And so Indiana takes this one by a big margin. Boy, they were something special to watch tonight, and the crowd loving every second of it.
It's always a great feeling when you play this well for your fans. This team really shows what it's capable of.
That concludes the first game of the NBA season. For Grant Hill, Clark Kellogg, and Allie LaForce, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching as we present our New Balance Player of the Game, Tyrese Halliburton.